In today's video, we're going to be talking about how ketones work and what exactly ketosis is. There is a lot of misinformation out there when it comes to ketones and ketosis. Do you have to be in ketosis to lose weight? Is ketosis dangerous? Is there an optimal ketone level you should be striving for? So in today's video, we are going to answer these questions and more and talk about how ketosis might benefit you. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Feel free to share and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by KETOSiCLE. KETOSiCLE is an all-in-one app that offers an educated approach to losing weight on keto. To save 85% off your personalized keto meal plan, head to ketocycle.diet/Kate2. So the keto diet has absolutely blown up in popularity over the last few years. More and more people are sharing their experiences on keto and telling stories of weight loss, healing, and an overall better quality of life. But as I said at the start, there are some misconceptions floating around surrounding keto, and these are turning some people away. So in this video, we are going to address these concerns, get an understanding of how ketosis works, and talk about how ketosis might be beneficial for you. What is ketosis? Ketosis is a metabolic state where the body is burning fat for energy. At a very basic level, your body essentially has two sources of energy: ketones from fat and glucose from carbohydrates. When we eat carbohydrates, they are turned to glucose by the body and can be used for energy. This is a quick source of energy for the body as carbs are broken down relatively quickly. But the downside is that there's only a limited amount of glucose that the body can store in our muscles and in our liver. So if you are relying on glucose for energy, you need to be continuously eating carbs throughout the day. Now, if the body didn't have a backup energy source for when we ran out of stored glucose, we would die. And that's where ketosis and ketones come in. Ketosis is a normal metabolic process. When your body senses your glucose stores are low, your liver starts to make ketones from fat. And ketones are another source of energy. But unlike glucose, where your body can only store a limited amount, around 2,000 calories worth, your body can store much more energy as fat, which can be converted into ketones. Even someone who is very lean can have over 100,000 calories worth of energy stored as fat. And of course, if you have more stored fat, you have more stored energy than this. But now let's talk a bit more about ketones specifically and how they work. Ketones. Ketones are a byproduct of the body breaking down fat to use for energy. This process happens when our stored glucose is depleted. For someone who is eating a high carb diet and keeping their glucose stores filled throughout the day, their body will not be producing many ketones. With that being said, most people will have some ketones present in their blood upon waking up in the morning, and this is because, obviously, you're not eating while you're sleeping. Now, one of the biggest benefits of burning fat and producing ketones is you're going to have stable energy throughout the day. And this is because, as we already spoke about, you have at least 100,000 calories of stored energy in your body that can be converted into ketones. But ketones do have some additional benefits that go beyond fat burning as well. Some of these include reduced inflammation, increased mental clarity, stable blood sugar, reversal of insulin resistance, and increased endurance performance. Generally, a ketone reading above 0.5 millimolars per liter is considered to be in ketosis. And you can measure this using a reader such as the one from Keto Mojo, which I will link down below. Although I will say that I do not think that tracking ketones religiously is necessary. Some people will just always register lower ketones than others. It is pretty well known that athletes actually have lower ketone readings on average than people who are sedentary. Does this mean that they are not in ketosis? No. The lower reading might simply mean that the body is producing and using ketones more efficiently. Now, at this point, you might be asking, if our bodies have all of this stored energy that can be converted into ketones, why is it so difficult to lose weight? So let's talk about that now. But before we get into metabolic flexibility, I'm going to take a quick moment to tell you about today's sponsor, KETOSiCYLE. The KETOSiCYLE app offers an educated approach to weight loss with the keto diet. An all-in-one keto assistant, the app provides you a personalized keto diet meal plan, grocery list, and a progress tracker, equipping you with the tools you need to lose weight. The app contains over 16,000 delicious keto diet recipes. I made these keto hash browns from the app the other day, and they were delicious. You also have the option to unlock an at-home personalized training plan, a premium function available for a one-time fee. And for as little as $1.25 per week, there is no reason not to give the KETOSiCYLE app a try. The team at KETOSiCYLE has been generous enough to offer all of my followers an 85% discount off a 12-month plan when they sign up through my link. Head to ketocycle.diet/kate2 to take the quiz and get your personalized keto diet meal plan. Thank you again to KETOSiCYLE for sponsoring this video. Metabolic flexibility. Metabolic flexibility means that your body is flexible to using whichever energy source is available. This means switching between burning carbs and fat for energy seamlessly. The problem is that most people are not metabolically flexible. Our diets rely so heavily around carbohydrates, bread, pasta, cereal, granola bars, etc. And we are all eating so often that our bodies rarely have the need to tap into our fat stores for energy. We get hungry and we eat immediately. Food is always available, but this comes at a price. When we are in a situation where we can't get food immediately, we suffer the consequences. We might experience a headache, fatigue, or even shakiness. And all of these symptoms are a sign that your body is not able to efficiently burn fat. But do not worry, there are ways you can increase your metabolic flexibility, one of which being the keto diet. And I have another video on the topic that will give you some more tips, and I will link that above. Is ketosis dangerous? Now, this is another question that I'm asked a lot. Is ketosis dangerous? And the answer is no, not for the average person. The only time that ketosis can potentially be dangerous is if you have type 1 diabetes. Because type 1 diabetics cannot produce insulin, this can lead to a buildup of ketones, and this is known as ketoacidosis. For the average person, ketones are either used or eliminated by the body and do not build up. But if you are a type 1 diabetic, it is really important that you work closely with your doctor before making any diet or lifestyle changes. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you measure and track your ketones and if you notice a difference if you have higher or lower readings. And if you did like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and click that subscribe button if you're not already. I post 2 videos every week. And if you are just getting started with the keto diet, the KETOSiCYLE app is a great resource. I will put the link to save 85% in the description box down below. If you guys did like this video, you might also like the video that I mentioned earlier on metabolic flexibility. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it right here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can find them here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.